Okay, let's talk about subtraction. There's really two parts to understanding subtraction, or really any mathematical operation, and that's understanding what it means and what understanding how to use it in base 10. And I'm actually going to break those up into two different pieces because they're really different, and the base 10 piece is its own problem. So let's just talk about subtraction and the meaning of subtraction today and some different ways to understand it. As always, we want to start from a place where the meaning is really clear. Often kids end up jiggling the symbols around and getting absorbed in a level of abstraction they may not be ready for. And if that's happening, make sure you have a visual or have a actual construction to do that makes it meaningful. Let me offer a few. For subtraction, I'm going to use the problem 13 minus 9 to demonstrate all of this. 13 minus 9. What does it mean? How could you do it? Well, one of the most basic things we could do, and maybe the first thing we would do, is actually build the number 13. Take 13 blocks, 13 paper clips, 13 anything you have around, make a group of 13 of them, and take away 9. How many are left? Kids can do this from quite a young age, and this is a great thing to return to as kind of our first principle if things get confused in other places. One pro tip here is, instead of just a mishmash of 13, try different organizations for those 13. Just applying organizations, especially groups of 10, can really help prepare the ground for what comes next. Another approach here, and actually a subtle but different and important approach, is to build and cover. So build 13, cover 9, how many are left? And I think that that's a really nice approach to remember, that you don't always have to take them fully away. In a way, they're sort of still there. And really, the 13 is just being broken into two pieces. Either one of the pieces can be covered or taken away, and the other one is what we're curious about. After you've done a sufficient amount of building and covering, you can move to just drawing this out. So actually draw 13 circles, cross out 9 of them. That's a nice thing to do and a nice approach here. And in general, there's kind of a movement between concrete to pictorial. You build it, you draw it, and then you actually record the meaning of it using the expressions and the equations. And that's how we fix the real understanding in our kids' minds. Another great model to use in all of this is the number line. And we can do 13 minus 9 on the number line in two different ways, very different ways, actually. One is we start at the number 13, and we understand subtracting 9 as moving to the left 9 spaces. If we start at 13 and walk left 9 spaces, we'll end up at the number 4. That's great. There's another approach to this also, which is we're saying, what's the difference between 13 and 9? That is, how far would you have to move left to get from 13 to 9? And that's also 4, but a very different model and understanding of what those two things mean. Both end up being important, and it's nice to be able to switch back and forth between them. So the number line is another place that we can get some really important practice. It's a little more abstract. A nice variation on the number line, especially when you're doing a lot of two-digit work, is a hundreds chart, which is just a number line that cycles back on itself and really accentuates the tens, which is going to be a big theme in all of arithmetic. So those are some ideas for subtraction. And if you have a bunch of subtraction problems to do with your kids, maybe you're trying to do splats, or maybe you're trying to do Diffie squares, or maybe you're just doing the homework that's coming home from school right now, try returning to one of those models when things feel like they're getting a little too abstract, a little too out of hand. And you'll find that by going back to those models, starting from understanding, you can build back up, and things will continue to make sense if you take small steps and go back up. So that's Crash Course in some subtraction modeling. And next, we'll talk about base 10.